So you might have noticed this week that ChatGPT has taken the world by storm. Within just 5 days of being released, it's already gained 1 million users. So you might be wondering, what is it, what it can do, and how you might be able to use it. Today, we're going to look at a wide range of examples of what it can do, including things like generating an original story, turning it into an adventure game, writing a formal legal style document, writing a technology patent, brainstorming app ideas to generate passive income, writing a business plan for one of them, eventually even coding it and turning it into a working prototype. Naturally, this sounds like an incredible piece of technology, but is it all just hype, or could it really be the start of something much bigger? Let's find out. When you load up ChatGPT, you'll see something like this. It's basically just a text box where you can type in anything you want. For instance, here I'm asking it, what is the largest French-speaking city in the world by population? And here it says Paris, France, with a population of 2.2 million people, which by the way sounds plausible, but is actually not correct. I'll reveal the real answer by the end of the video. You could also use it to generate ideas, kind of like a brainstorming partner. For example, here I'm gonna ask it to give me 5 app ideas to generate passive income that can be developed and maintained by one person. And sure enough, ChatGPT delivers. Here we have it suggesting things like a subscription-based meal planning grocery delivery service, a fitness app that provides personalized workout plans, a virtual event planning and management platform, a personal finance and budgeting app, and a marketplace for buying and selling secondhand items. And it even elaborates a little bit further on each idea with how you can make money from it and what the business would look like to operate. Now, none of these ideas particularly blow me away, but they're solid enough. So let's see if we can take it further. Next, I'm gonna ask ChatGPT to see if it can flesh out a business plan for one of these ideas. So here I'm gonna say, okay, write me a business plan for the second idea, the workout app. And here it goes on to give me an executive summary. The goal of the app is to provide users with personalized workout plans, track their progress, help them reach their fitness goals. It gives me a market analysis. The fitness industry is highly competitive. Target audience. It's even got a section on marketing and sales. It mentions the revenue model, so it'll be in-app purchases and subscription fees, team and resources. It can be developed and maintained by a single person, so it's good to see that GPT still remembers that requirement from us from the first prompt. And the conclusion is, overall, the fitness app has potential to be a successful and profitable business, meeting a strong demand in the market for personalized and convenient workout solutions. Now, what if I actually want to go ahead and build a prototype for this? So first, let's start by asking ChatGPT to come up with a list of different exercises we can put into our workout. And sure enough, it does this, and it can even list the muscle groups that they exercise. But what if I wanted to see the information in the form of a table? Well, it turns out GPT has no problem handling that as well. Now, what if I want to turn this into an actual app? So my next prompt for it is, write a Python Flask app for a workout generator. It lets the user input how many minutes they want to work out to be, and we will pick randomly from a list of workouts to create a personalized plan. Now, I did have to try a couple of different prompts for this at first, and I found that it works best when you can be more specific about what you want. But anyway, it looks like here it's generating my Python app, and it's even given me instructions on how to run it. So let's give it a shot. And after following the instructions and then running it locally on my web server, I can see that the app works fine, but it just kind of returns all the workouts in a list like this without, you know, any kind of instruction on what sequence I should perform them in or how long I should be doing them. So let's ask ChatGPT to improve that. How do I modify it so the output is in JSON format and it tells me how long to do each workout for? And each workout should be between 2 and 8 minutes. So here it is actually rewriting the entire app for me based on the previous prompts, but it's making that modification. Now, this example kind of shows one of the limitations of ChatGPT, that when you want even very small changes to an existing piece of code or existing thing that it's already written, it rewrites the whole thing again instead of just showing you how to make that specific change. Compared to something like GitHub Copilot, which is more surgical in its recommendations, this can be really good for sort of general high-level things, but if you start wanting to have more control or do more specific things, I think it does become a little bit more challenging. Now, when I copied the code and tried to run it again, I actually ran into a server error. So it seemed like ChatGPT made a few mistakes in this code. The work it did was mostly correct, but I found that I actually had to spend a little bit of time just manually fixing some of those bugs. Not a big problem though. After fixing those bugs, I ran it again, and sure enough, here is the properly formatted JSON output with the workout and the duration. The data is there, but it's still pretty raw. To show this as a web page, I need to have an HTML template. So here's going to be my next prompt. Generate an HTML Jinja template to have an input field to enter the workout duration and to display the results from the JSON as a table. So off it goes, and it's saying, here is an example Jinja template that you can use to create an HTML page with an input field for the workout duration and a table to display the results from the JSON data. And it's gone ahead and just written the entire HTML template for me. It's even given me instructions on how to use it. So to use the template, you would need to pass the JSON data returned by the Flask app as a variable named plan. So here it says to render a file named template.html, you can use the render template method. And it gives me an example. Note that I will need to have the template HTML file saved in a templates directory within the Flask app. So I followed the instructions and the website's starting to come together. I can look at the workouts as a table, and there's even a button I can use to put in the workout name and generate new personalized workouts. It still looks pretty bland though, so let's go ahead and ask ChatGPT if it can make it look a little bit better for us by generating a CSS style. And here's how the app looks now with the CSS modifications that GPT recommended. So we've got a branding color, we've got a more modern font, and I think the table looks better as well. And to finish off, let's also ask it to come up with a name for the app along with some marketing text. The first prompt is, come up with 5 title suggestions for a workout generator app. And it's got Fit Gen, Workout Mixer, Sweatify, Body Fit Planner, and Fitness Fusion. Next, they'll ask it to generate a brief and snappy and motivating copy for the landing page of the app. And here's what it comes up with. Tired of the old same workout routine? Mix things up with Fit Gen. Our app allows you to create custom workouts, tailored to your fitness levels and goals. Say goodbye to boring workouts. Hello to a fitter, healthier you with Fit Gen. Try it now and get fit fast. Okay, that sounds pretty good. So after putting all that in, here's what the finished product looks like. I can now put in how many minutes I want to train for, and it generates a personalized workout plan based on that. I think it's pretty incredible that we were able to go from zero to this almost entirely by just conversing in plain human language with ChatGPT. Sure, there were a little bit of bugs and hiccups along the way, but this technology already goes a long way to help us prototype new ideas really quickly. Now, just reflecting on this coding section, I do want to point out some of the problems I've noticed with it as a coding assistant. By default, ChatGPT is actually quite chatty. And even if I ask it for a small change or a snippet, it tends to try rewriting the whole thing from scratch. So that's a bit of a sharp edge for me because it does make the development process quite slow compared to something like GitHub Copilot. Another thing that ChatGPT seems to be really good at is that it can generate some content, whatever content you want, in a completely unrelated style. And that's actually a really fun thing to try. For example, here, I'm gonna ask it to express the rules of Secret Santa, but as a formal legal letter. Gift limit is $50. Dear participants in the Secret Santa gift exchange, please adhere to the following rules. Each participant must contribute a wrapped gift with a value not exceeding $50. The identity of the gift giver must remain a secret until the designated time for the gift exchange. We look forward to a fun and festive Secret Santa experience. Happy holidays. So now you know, next time you need something to sound official, you can just ask ChatGPT to write it for you. After that example, I had another idea. A couple of years ago, I was working on a patent at the company that I worked for, and I remember the lawyers billing us something like $500 per hour just to translate software concepts into legal language. So let's see if ChatGPT can actually do that for free. And here, I'm gonna ask it to write me a patent for the technique of turning it off and on again. And here's what it comes up with. Patent application. A method for resolving technical issues using power cycling is disclosed. The method involves turning off a device and then turning it back on again in order to reset the device and potentially resolve any technical issues. The method can be applied to a wide variety of devices. Identify the device that is experiencing the technical issue, turn off the device, wait for a period of time, such as 10 seconds, to allow the device to fully shut down. Turn the device back on. Observe the device to determine if the technical issue has been resolved. I mean, just reading that, it sounds very close to something like what I expect a lawyer to say. Now, I don't really have any idea how close it is to being viable legal writing, but I'm sure there's still gonna be a lot of really disruptive use cases from this. By the way, you could probably also do the reverse and ask ChatGPT to explain a complex legal contract for you in simple terms. What about creative content? Well, it turns out that ChatGPT is also pretty impressive for creative prompts. For example, I can ask it to draw a cat in ASCII art or a cat with a ball. But where it really shines is narratives, especially if you mix ideas together. For example, I asked it here to tell me the story of Little Red Riding Hood in the style of Lovecraftian horror, and it came up with some really vivid scenes. Like, as Little Red Riding Hood made her way through the forest, she noticed that the trees seemed to whisper and writhe in the wind. Inside, she found her grandmother lying in bed, pale and sickly, but there was something off about her. Her eyes were glowing with an otherworldly light. I think it's really amazing that it's able to synthesize these two sort of very different ideas into a coherent response. Here's another example where I asked it to write a short adventure story about Jack and his dog, again with the Eldritch horror theme since I enjoyed it so much the first time. And as you expect, it does a pretty good job of that as well. I'm not gonna read the entire response, but just going through the story, it seems to be very well put together. So it's got the theme, each paragraph advances the story, and there's a classical three-act structure with the beginning, the middle or the conflict, and then the end with a resolution to the story. Now, the story sounds like it could be the narrative for an adventure or a board game. So I asked it to tell the story as an interactive story, almost like a dungeon master, and then give me options to choose from. So here it gives me a couple options, A, B, and C. In the first one, we can decide to continue exploring the cave, searching for more treasures and artifacts. In the second one, we can choose to retreat. In the third one, option C, we can try to find the source of the strange noises and the creatures and try to uncover the secrets of the cave. So I'm gonna go ahead and just type C, and it kind of just picks up and continues the story based on that prompt. Notice that one of the unique features of ChatGPT is that it maintains the context of the whole conversation. So even with a short one-letter prompt like C, it is able to pull context from the entire conversation history to give me the reply that kind of continues that trajectory. And I could see a lot of use cases for creative or entertainment uses of GPT. For example, an AI-powered board game experience, especially combined with AI art generation tool like DALL-E or Midjourney. By the way, if you're interested to see how this AI can be used to build something like that, then leave a comment in the video and let me know what your ideas are, because I think it'd be quite fun, and if people are interested, then maybe we can build it together. Also, I'm gonna put a transcript of all of these prompts into the video description, so if you want to take a closer look at any of the examples we covered today, then just scroll down and click on that link. So now that you've seen some examples of what ChatGPT can do, what do you think about it? Do you think it could change the world, or is it something that's just gonna blow over? Let me know in the comments. My first impression is that its knowledge base is extremely wide, and it's also exceptionally good at synthesizing very different ideas together, as we've seen from the examples. However, it doesn't go very deep, and it begins to struggle as the prompts become more complex. To get the workout app to where it was, I actually had to reprompt it several times and fix some of the bugs by hand. It can also serve up false or outdated information. So remember the first question we asked? Even though Paris sounds like the correct answer as the most populous French-speaking city in the world, it was actually dethroned in 2016 by Kinshasa in the Republic of Congo. However, despite these limitations, I still think it's an extremely exciting piece of technology, and I think it will unlock a lot of opportunities for anybody who can find a way to leverage its potential. Speaking of which, if you're interested in this and you want to try it out for yourself, then head on over to chat.openai.com and create an account. It's in public beta right now, and anyone can create an account and try it for free, although I don't know how long that will last for. In the coming weeks, I plan to spend a bit more time exploring generative AI and seeing how we can incorporate that into larger scale projects. If you're interested to see how that turns out, then please subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss those updates. And if you enjoyed learning about ChatGPT today, then also consider checking out my other videos where I talk about its close cousins, GitHub Copilot and GPT-3, which were developed by the same parent company, OpenAI. Finally, I asked ChatGPT to write a sign-off for me for this video, and here is what it had to say. Go ahead and give ChatGPT a try. We promise you, you won't be disappointed. Except, you know, if you were hoping to do some actual work. In that case, you're out of luck. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.